So here's how you can handle custom information at the sale order level, right? So with the configurator, I have it set up so that we can input some custom values, things like that. Now, let's configure this product. Apple Watch, size small, color white, length, 120 cm, volume, 1,000 milliliters, whatever custom values we want. It adds those values here. And now when I confirm this, it generates a manufacturing order because this is make to order. And when I go to manufacturing, I can see my custom values automatically tracked here. And then I could go in and modify products that are going to be consumed based off of based off the amount. So I could go in and say we really consume 0.5, and this is how you can introduce some element of customization. So it would be you could say, you know, maybe we produced 0.5, which is less than the initial amount, you know, 0.9, save, lock, check availability, produce, and I think you should have actually done it here, 0.9, so not at the other stage, my apologies, and record production, and it doubled that, it made a I screwed that up, but you can see you could control that through here, and then mark it as done. So that's one way to do it. Let's try it one more time. So that's how, so I like this because like at the configurator level, right, at the product variant, we can actually go in and control the custom values. Right, so we can say, you know, length, and maybe I want this to be a select, or a color is a custom value. Volume. So you could even say like size, and we could have it. Maybe it could also be a custom value. So let's see. Wait. So let's see how this responds. Oops, configure. Size, we could select small, and then we could say 1.5 inch wristband. And then we could also say length, 4 inch wrist band, and the volume maybe 250 ml. And then when we add that, it captures all that here. See? So you can capture that information. And then when you confirm it, it tells me I have to define a bond now because it's a small black. I screwed that up. So what we can do is just exit this. We want, because small black doesn't have a unique bomb set to it. Small white does. And we'll say, 15 cm. Wristband, white, length, this value, 150 ml, 4-inch wrist. Add, right, those are all custom values. Perfect. Confirm, generates it, go to manufacturing, and just like that, we have it right here. And then whoever, then your bill of materials, right, it would, you know what products you need, but you just probably don't know how much of that product you're going to need for the custom job. And then you can go in, and what you'll do is you'll begin working on it. And let me just figure out the best way to do this. When you click produce, it seems you'll enter those values here. Maybe I only consumed half of the raw materials that I initially had reserved. And it only consumes half from my stock. That's perfect. Yep, you've consumed less than planned. Yep, I want to close the MO. And my stock moves should reflect the half. And they do. So you could tell your customer that, you know, if you can have somewhat of a defined list of bill of materials, you know, the amount of products you can consume, and both, you know, whether or not you want to consume them and the quantities that you want to consume are modifiable at the production level. So again, if we you know, if we have a Apple Watch, and if I want to check availability and produce, you can modify these here, or I could add additional products on the fly that I want to use in the production. Or I could just create a brand new bill of material from scratch by making this not read only, or making it state equals, you know, done. Read only if the properties are applied, which should unleash it. Not yet, but it's customizable. So that's something to think about. If you need help with it, let me know.